Hello, all Branson off-grid.com fans. I want to show you this electric vertical takeoff and landing from lift aircraft. So this will be the start of my update for December, probably the last one of the year. Got a few exciting things to add here today, a few different topics queued up. And this is a ultralight vertical takeoff and landing. It's kind of like a personal drone. In other words, it only seats one person, so it's not as big as an air taxi, but the good thing about it is it's an ultralight. These will be available for purchase out of Austin, Texas, so if you buy one, you should look at their website. We'll go to it here in a minute, but they've got some good options. Main thing is being an ultralight classification, it's under 254 pounds, and you don't need a any type of a license, pilot's license, in other words. In fact, ultralights have been around. I used to build ultralights back in the 80s, so it's a neat machine. It'll be quite pricey, but you see, it's also got floats on it, so it can actually sit down in the water if need be. Not a very long flight time, but I believe that's getting ready here to change. Probably by the time they get to actually sell these things in any kind of quantity, the battery technology will probably double the range. Right now, because of the weight, you're limited to 254 pounds or less, so it's very light carbon fiber construction, multi-rotor. Single person with just a joystick control, so it's not autonomous. You drive it, you fly it, I should say, yourself. Got a lot of neat benefits. The idea is that something like this, someone could get in, they could go to work. Right now, this one here will probably only have a 8 to 15 minute flight time, probably max out around 55 miles per hour, something like that. But for short hops, flying to work, the big thing with the ultralight is you can't fly around populated areas, so you'd be pretty restricted on what you can use it for, but the fact that you can use it with floats on it and land in the water possibly, that could might be helpful for some people. Maybe that, for example, they live on a lake. Work on one side of the lake, live on the other side of the lake, they could just hop across the water and come and land at a dock, for example. That could be a great possibility for a lot of people. Instead of going across in a boat, you could just go in something you can charge up in your garage, fly across the lake, land at a dock, and go up from there to your business. So there are a lot of people that could use that. So let's bump out of here and go over to, let me see where I want to go. I'm using OBS here, so I've got this, and I hope that is going to show full screen as well. Let me just kind of glance back. No, I don't think that does. All right, well, let's go back here because, I see what I've done mistakenly. I didn't have that full screen in this screen. All right, that should be full screen now. So, yeah, all right. So, anyway, here's my Branson Solar and the domain name. If you go up here, it'll show you it's BransonOffGrid.com. And I just did a video update on this electric VTOL, flying taxis, Aquion, so forth. So, I'm going to kind of improve on this video that I shot last time, which is only about a month old. And we're gonna go over here and look at lift aircraft and their website. Well, I thought I had the website pulled up, but I guess not. It's liftaircraft.com. Okay, I got some things on hydrogen I'm gonna show you today, batteries. And batteries. So I didn't pull up their website, but it's liftaircraft.com. You should go on here to YouTube and you can see their channel. What I've recommended a lot of people is to just buy a domain name and use the domain and have it the domain just point to their YouTube site, so they can just give people a domain name. Otherwise, you're kind of stuck with this all this these characters in your channel name, and you pretty much just have to give them this the name. Of course, lift aircraft is very simple, but some channel names, you might have 10 channels with basically the same name, so it could get very confusing trying to get somebody to find your channel. And giving a link is not handy if you have all these gibberish characters, so you have to do it by email, for example. But if you buy a domain name, and then you just have the domain name redirect to your YouTube channel name, that link, in other words, then you can just hand people a domain name, and that is their YouTube channel. So you would use one domain for your liftaircraft.com, for example, and then you would use a liftaircraft dash, or you might not want to put YouTube in the in your domain name, but you could put YT or something, and that one could be the one that goes to your YouTube channel. So that's just a good way of using domains. At any rate, they don't have a whole lot on here right now, but we were kind of looking at this one in the background here, where they have their beta flight. The big thing about the lift aircraft that we're looking at is that they're going to let you sign up at their website to fly these things. They've already sold out a number of cities. I think they said they had about 13,000 pre-sales or something already, or maybe it was 1,300. But at any rate, they're going to set up these in various cities where you can just go in and fly, take a short course where you're going to train on flying it, and then they're going to basically control it with let's just look at this one, for example, geofenced area, for example, and then in other words, they'll be able to keep control of the aircraft even while you're flying it. Now, this is kind of an older version from what we were looking at, but as you can see, you'll be they'll maybe let you go 100 feet up in the air. It'll be geofenced. In other words, they'll have control from the ground, but they'll still have a joystick, and you'll be able to go up and fly it. And if you do something crazy, they'll be able to take over control from the ground so you don't crash it. And right now, I think they're advertising $250 for 15 minutes where you'll be able to sign up on their website and fly these. And what they're trying to get is people to buy them and maybe to lease them back to their company, so you can actually make money off of your aircraft, unless it's something you want to fly on a regular basis. Small enough to, I don't know if you can get it in your garage, but you can get it in some type of building and charge it up at your house and go out and play with it if you want. Or maybe, like I said, some people can use them in certain situations. But ultralight, you can't get around a populated area, so you have to look at the restrictions. All right, let's enough on that. I want to talk about batteries today, but one of the things I want people to look at is this newatlas.com. You should go in here and sign up and get their, in fact, this is probably where I found Lift Aircraft, was on New Atlas. It used to be called Gizmag. Now it's called New Atlas. At any rate, a lot of new technology. You get an email every day with 5 or 10 different things that on technology. This is a good thing here about being able to make hydrogen. So we've talked about a hydrogen economy, which would be a clean economy. Actually, your cars run on gasoline, but it's the hydrogen in the gasoline that produces the power. And running vehicles off of hydrogen would be great, except making the hydrogen is such a problem, and that can be a very dirty business depending on how it's made. You can make hydrogen clean from solar and so forth, but storing it is a problem. Now, they don't really talk about making your own hydrogen and storing that hydrogen locally, which would be the best way to go about it, but still the amount of energy used to make the hydrogen is a big problem. So here they've made a way to, because normally you make it out, in fact, I'll tell you right here, you split it out of water using electrolysis. So I put the water in a container and apply power. Oxygen gathers at the anode, hydrogen at the cathode, and then if you've done it with solar, that's good. But then you have to store it. Now, you can store it at low pressure. Most of the hydrogen that people are talking about, they want to sell you for like a car or transport, would be a high pressure, like 10,000 pounds or something like that. So if you make use high pressure hydrogen, it has to be extremely clean. You can't have any oxygen mixed in with the hydrogen, or it would explode when you pressurize it. However, you can use it at low pressure, down around 400 pounds, I think is about what low pressure would be, and you can store it in same thing you would use for storing propane, same kind of tanks at home, and you could actually store your own hydrogen, make some from solar, and then use that to run a backup generator, for example, if you wanted to be off-grid. So that's one good thing. But what this article is about is how it's a much more efficient way. They call it green hydrogen versus brown hydrogen, which is gasoline. Okay. So it says it's got a paper published in Nature Communications. They've replaced the expensive platinum on the carbon catalyst, which is the way it's normally split, and they're using a catalyst with nickel iron oxide interface, and they've been able to split at the highest energy efficiency, which is 83.7%. So much more efficient than what we've had. This could change things dramatically. So you should go over here and read this article, and then they've got a article here that goes to. And the other thing about the hydrogen is I like to talk some about using hydrogen for health, and here's your perfect article. If you go to Dr. McCullough, which is just McCullough on YouTube, and look at his latest article on here, Alex Tarnava. Yeah, let's just go over here. Yeah, there you go. Alex Tarnava, I guess. And he discusses molecular hydrogen. You should go over here and listen to this article. This is just an amazing thing for improving your health, and you can do it. The good thing about hydrogen is it can be done at inexpensive. And he talks about using tablets, how he invented these tablets where you take them and they make hydrogen in your stomach. So this is one of the cheapest ways, unless you have a good hydrogen generator, and he talks a little bit about that. He started with buying a hydrogen generator, and those, even to date, I think some of the best ones are up around $5,000. Now, here's another good one over here. This is Tyler LeBaron, which runs the Molecular Hydrogen Institute out of Florida, and it gives you some links down there. At any rate, this is a this is in another language. All right, well, we won't go look at that, but you should look up Tyler LeBaron and hydrogen on YouTube. He's got another channel. In fact, it might just be listed over here, but I don't see it. And I see what he says about using hydrogen for health. So we should go into a long thing on that one day. I had talked about using Simplify Power lithium-ion batteries for off-grid systems, and this PH3.8, I think, is the biggest one. It's just called simplifypower.com. This is their website. And this page here tells you a little bit about what's good about these lithium-ion batteries compared to, and they use them for all types of systems, commercial, but I look at off-grid, what can be used for off-grid. And this is a really good, say, residential and commercial battery banks, and that can be grid-tie and off-grid and all that kind of thing. But here's some great things about this Simplify lithium-ion battery, and the prices on these are getting down to where they're being installed in larger numbers every year, more and more. And this is one of the best ones. 10-year warranty, expected life 15 to 20 years. Cycle one to several times a day, and they talk about, here you go, 5, 10,000 cycle life at 80% depth of discharge. So it's one of the best batteries out there for off-grid residential use, price-wise, and very efficient, 98% efficiency charge and discharge rate, which is probably the highest in the industry at the moment, I'm guessing, but I think it is. So very good warranty, it's made in the United States. So as far as lithium ion batteries for off-grid systems, residential and commercial, to simplify power is one of the best out there. Now here, you go over here and you can see the YouTube page is linked here. I already have it pulled up. This is the 3.8. They have these in 24 volt and 48 volt setups. I believe this is 48 volt. Well, that's neat, but then they say. But you can go here and pull down the white pages, simplifiedpower.com, and see how these, it's a lithium ferrophosphate chemistry. There's no cobalt, so there's no risk of thermal runaway or fire, which is exactly what you want for off-grid, especially residential. So it's compatible with all industry standard inverters and charge controllers. So it's basically plug and play if you have lithium, another, you know, lithium ion or lead acid or whatever, it doesn't really matter. It's plug and play with whatever inverter and charge controller that you would already have. So if you're going to upgrade batteries, you should look at this Simplify Power. However, and let's look at their YouTube. Well, I've got to pull it up. Simplify Power. Go in here, look at their videos. There's a lot of information here about how to integrate their batteries into various. In fact, they talk about using Schneider, Outback, and so forth. However, and we're going to come back to that. Let's go over here to Kilowatt Labs. Now, this is a new product. This is like the holy grail of batteries, which is now available. Maybe not something the general public can just buy and install. However, they're selling it through, I believe, integrators or resellers, distributors, whatever, to commercial integrators and that kind of thing. But it'll be available. And it's a capacitor battery, which is much better than what we were just looking at. Even with the lithium ion, I think you'll find that this is a much better way to go. And if you look, and here's a picture of one in a rack. So you can come over here, get their white papers, look over their key attributes. But just so many things about capacitor batteries that are going to be energy density 78 watt hours per kilogram. So you can compare these with lithium ion, and they already have some written up here over chemical batteries, they say over here. The biggest thing is, one of the biggest things that's going to sell these is the million cycle. So their cell cycle life projected is going to be around a million cycles. So where most lithium ions, the Simplify was the highest cycle life I've seen at 10,000. This one's a million. So you get whatever the price of the batteries to compare. If you're looking at one that has a 5,000 cycle life or 10,000 cycle life versus how much power it holds, you know, if you're doing something off grid, you're not necessarily worried about size and all that kind of thing, but you are worried about you know, how long it's going to last. So you have to figure this 1 million cycle life when you finally find out what these cost. I haven't really looked into it, but very high efficiency, 99% constant over life. Usable capacity, here's another thing. You can drain it to 100% and it charges at a very high rate. So it's a very fast charging battery, and when you drain it, you can drain it all the way down 100%. So not like a normal battery at all. And it doesn't degrade, so this usable capacity, 100% constant over life, where most batteries degrade. This one says 50 to 80%, but they're probably talking, maybe they're not talking lithium there necessarily. So, just so many good things here in this capacitor battery idea. It's really been the holy grail. Now it's available. No maintenance on the warehousing, no worry about it catching on fire. The environmental impact of disposal is none compared to lithium and lead acid and that kind of thing, disposal cost. Here's your energy density, but I'm not sure what they're comparing it to. No risk of thermal runaway, where other ones, especially lithiums, have a medium to high risk of thermal runaway. However, to simplify, better I was showing it does not have a, it has a, probably a low to none risk of thermal runaway because of the type of lithium. There's at least 10 different lithium technologies out there that you can buy. So that was to simplify. Might not have as much power density, but it has no medium or no risk. So that's a big plus. Plus on that side. So here you've got all your data sheets you can download, and they've got some 48, you see they got 12, 24, and 48 volt batteries. So I think this is what we're going to see going in, and this is actually a picture of one. I see we got two different, oh, this top part I think is just a controller, or maybe this one is the actual battery pack over here. And it's a battery capacitor. But a good thing, like I said, it has very fast charge and fast high amp discharge rates and all that kind of thing. So it's going to be the holy, it's really going to be the holy grail for off-grid. Here's their Kilowatt Labs. And again, it's got this channel with all this gibberish in it. So you'll have to just search for Kilowatt Labs. Subscribe to that. They don't have a whole lot of stuff here, but they're giving new stuff every month. They're putting a video up. And if you go to the website, they'll show you where you can buy their products from. I didn't see a seller in the United States, but they have a whole bunch of other ones. Now, our last thing I want to talk about is this Rude Awakening and Mount Sinai, because there's just an upgrade new video broadcast from Mount Sinai. In fact, we'll just go over and look at this. And here, let's just do full screen of that. Okay. So, one of the new things I told you before, we talked about Mount Sinai, and now there's availability for people to go to Mount Sinai on a tourist visa. You'll be able to go, I don't know, I guess up to the top. Maybe you can, if you can walk up to the top, it's 7,000 feet, 7,500 feet to the peak, I think. So it would be a heck of a trip. Not many people could probably go up to the top, but you can come up to it from the bottom. There'll be tours available, and you can get a tourist visa into Saudi Arabia to, and here is Andrew Jones, I think, and he's doing a broadcast. There you go, Andrew Jones, documentarian. Yeah, he's done a lot of the 4K video. We talked a little bit about him before, and I told you he was doing a lot of drone videos. So he's, there's two movies coming up by Timothy Mahoney. He's, some of his video is going to be in those movies. One of them is going to show the exodus across the Gulf of Aqaba, and then up to the mountain, and then the second one is going to be about the mountain itself. And so this is exciting things. Everything, like I said before, Ron Wyatt found this back in the 80s, and the Saudis have known about it, but now they're, in fact, they just put a cell phone tower up right up here behind them, like that, Mount Sinai in Saudi Arabia, live. So he's broadcasting from where he's standing at the bottom of the mountain through the cell phone tower, and doing a video with Michael Rood. And Michael Rood's done a lot of previous videos on Mount Sinai. So, but that's standing right there. I think he's on the east side of the mountain looking west, because I showed you, when I was doing that last video, you could see this basically the same shot right up over my head in the last video I did on my channel. So you should go to Michael Rood's A Rude Awakening. Let's bring that back down. There you go. So here's his channel. a Rude Awakening on YouTube and go over and look at this first ever live broadcast from Mount Sinai today. It was just put up today. So, all right. And like I said, before long, they'll be have flying taxis. I assume they'll be flying people right over the top of the mountain so they can see this whole area and all of the artifacts that are mentioned in Exodus. Like I said, everything mentioned in the book of Exodus is still right here on one side or the other of the mountain, along with Mount Oreb and the Rock of Oreb and all that. So all of this is still here, and the Saudis have protected that for all these years. So now they're bringing people in. So you can be one of the first people to go there, and maybe within the next year or two, they'll have people flying people over in electric flying taxis. So that's my update for December, and I hope everybody will be right here. And there was my last video's update on electric video flying taxis, and I talked a little bit about the green saltwater battery, because I have a Aquion saltwater battery, and that's still a viable technology, but I think this new battery capacitor idea is just going to blow everybody out of the water. The capacitor battery actually should be cheaper than lithium ion, but they, when they first come out, which they just come out, they're probably not going to be. I don't know what the price is, because they're not advertising that, but at any rate, oh, electric flying taxis around Mount Sinai, so we could fly at the top of a mountain of Jehovah, maybe. I would sign up for that when it becomes available. Yeah, that's funny. So I was just talking about that. All right, well, I'm going to sign out, and we'll go back to, All right, so I think this is an Austin where you did this flight, so come back to BransonOffGrid.com. That'll bring you right to my YouTube channel. And this is basically a vlog, in other words. And my email will be david@BransonOffGrid.com if you need to contact me. And I help people get off-grid residential systems, figure out what they want to buy and what works for them and that kind of thing. So I appreciate you visiting, and I'll probably do another upgrade update in January or whenever when I've got some new video to show you, new information. So thanks for watching.